Hey guys, your Broker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool career mode where I last time
have to. Oh wait. Completely forgot I'm not doing recaps anymore. Derp.
Whoops. My mistake.
My bad.
That's my bad. Oh man. Sorry. But yeah, go back and watch the last episode. I'm not gonna babysit anyone anymore. I don't give a shit.
You're here for one reason and one reason only. You're here to watch some Liverpool career mode.
If you cared about what happened in the last episode, you would have watched the last episode.
Hello once again, I'm Martin Tyler and this is Anfield. The game today, Liverpool, and they face
Southampton in this episode.
Liverpool that have kicked off. Big reshuffle for Liverpool. Thibaut Courtois starts in goal. David Alaba starts with Nathaniel Klein. Is
going for goal!
That's a fine strike.
Bulge in the back of the net.
That's the first... touch was good, but he's got to work hard. Set the pace for his match. I do want to talk about something.
It's got a bit of menace to it.
Now this will
came in with a challenge.
Have happened only recently.
Until that point, when it broke down, and now they've got to try and regain.
This video will be up on Wednesday, I think. Yeah, Wednesday. This video was Wednesday.
Good play.
Now, something went. I kind of screwed up and I accidentally uploaded two videos on one day.
Fine save.
One of those videos was supposed to be
he heads it for goal and it's a shot now
for another day.
And like most things he does, he's got an air of grace about it.
Such. So two videos went up one day and I have nothing. There will be no video this past Saturday. There'll be nothing. Like, it'll be like I vanished from the face of the planet.
Has opened the scoring.
It's not a day off. I accidentally did a double upload, so I'm like, well, fuck it. Double upload, and that's the secondary career mode. I know it doesn't already have any precedent here. I've also talked about it in the second secondary career mode video. The next one you guys see, which will be up the day. This is pre-recorded. Just so you know, this is pre-recorded. I'm actually recording this on Saturday, so it's not like I did take the day off. I have to record 8 videos today. This is the first of them. it's going to be a long day.
An opening. The referee had a good look at that, decided it's just a throw after the tackle.
Yeah.
And in goes the cross. Has to score here. He's kept it out. McCarthy keeps...
I don't know what happened. I was clearly not paying attention. Or I don't know if it was a YouTube fuck-up. I don't know. Should be crazy on YouTube right now. People aren't getting ads. That's YouTube.
Ruiz.
So YouTube is paying nobody. People are getting mad subs. Bullshit videos are being recommended to people who have absolutely no idea why they're getting recommended these random videos from these random people who they didn't even know the channels existed. A lot of crazy shit is going on. It's bad times. Like, if you do YouTube for a job, if you don't get ads, you are fucked.
Lay it off to the supporting player.
A real chance here, Matip.
All the big YouTubers that I watch are complaining.
And that really has given them much more of a basis for the rest of this match.
And frankly so. I mean, you know, this is like one of their main sources of income. For some of them, it's their only source because they do it as a joke because they're like, they reach such a level of popularity, people constantly watching their videos and their jobs. Now, some of the not so big, but you know, still have, you know, they're still
causing a problem to the opposition here. Little width
are on their way there, probably. It's just all, it's all messed up
against Liverpool.
It is all messed up.
Ambitious free kick. The ambition almost paid off.
So,
didn't think he was going to go for goal,
yeah,
there, but he did. And yeah, as you
for
say,
once,
too far away.
I am happy I do this as a pastime. If I did this as a career, I would be, like, I'd be just as mad. I'd be pissed. I'd be fucking tweeting YouTube. I'd be trying to get in contact with them any way I could. So, if any of you all know, yeah, oh, know any of the big YouTubers, like, tell them, you know, say it to YouTube. I know they are, but you know, really, make sure, don't give YouTube a break. Send them multiple messages, send them multiple tweets. Just berate them, barrage them. Flood them with
Oriol Romeo. A lot of defenders
tweet, message, this, that, and everything else. Send them all your complaints.
Well, that's always the goal.
Over and over again. Until they say, okay, fuck it, we'll fix this. Because, you know, that's bullshit, you know? From someone who doesn't do this as, who does this as a pastime and as a pastime slash hobby, it doesn't affect me because I don't get paid from YouTube anyway. But for someone who does, who relies on this to, you know, feed themselves, feed their families, feed their pets if they have them, that's bullshit.
Looking good, this move.
This shouldn't be the case.
Nicely worked until that point when it broke down. Now they've got
to supposed to get paid if you do a job.
He got there just in time. In the end, a fantastic clearance.
A lot of the big YouTubers are setting up Patreons. Because of all the bullshit going on with YouTube.
It is looking,
I say fair play to them. I mean, a lot of them have
the situation for them should be
fans who will probably pledge lots of money to them anyway, because they're like, I really enjoy this guy's content. I make sure, do my part to make sure that his content stick. He's where I can view it.
Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation. Well, this is how this team can play sustained attacking football. But when they lose it, as they've done now, it's just a risk that they might get caught out.
Oh. How? I mean, I support, or as many YouTubers on the YouTubers I watch on Patreon, well, the ones that have Patreon,
with us, the
some
EFL
don't.
Cup fixture, Liverpool, they'll be facing Spurs away from home.
Yeah, it's got a good
the ones that do, who I support them in the for it, with as much as I can.
Norwich, Alan McAnally.
Because they keep me here. They deserve to get paid for their hard work.
Alan McAnally keeping us up to date as usual. He's spotting it up now to take the call. And it's a heading chance now.
If you do follow a YouTuber who has a Patreon and you really enjoy that person's work, if you can, donate.
Good work by the goalkeeper.
It can be as low as one.
And moving on, Alan. Ahead, Southampton's next game.
They're playing Manchester City in the next match. And do you know what, Martin? Yeah. I think it's going to be
that
tough. That
can go a long way if enough people do it. So.
It's Ward-Prowse. 20 minutes now.
This is something to keep in the back of your mind, gentlemen.
Patience is the name of the game at the moment. A real chance here. There'll be a signal here at the corner.
Anyway, focus, turn focus back on the gameplay. Currently 3-0 up so far here on SM. Joel Matip got that second goal, which is, was a bit odd.
Southampton lining up a substitution now.
I heard he might miss the Crystal Palace game, as if we had in, as if we didn't have enough injuries, I should say.
And it steered back to the goalkeeper, Courtois. Good forward play from them. It's a quick
one, Sanio. One! Yes!
Almost stealthily into scoring position here.
Get in. I think that's Mane's fifth goal this season.
It was a great race, a great pace, and a fantastic.
Yes, indeed. Fantastic. Good job, Sanio.
What a counter-attack.
The goals seem to be well spaced out. No one's running away with the top goal scorer.
7 minutes to go.
Like, five is really the most I have. Matip has two goals. He's only three behind that. He's an hat-trick away from being level with Sadio Mane. A centre-back.
That's how they love to play on the break.
Who has scored
strong tackle
almost the same amount in one season as he has in the past few seasons. I think he has like 5 or 6 goals in the past 3 seasons.
Got the tackle in.
Club. I can't quite remember how many goals he's scored in the past 3 seasons.
He's got the ball but in the offensive zone by reading the play.
Two of this
well.
Early on is like.
Has indicated 3 more minutes.
Damn, that's impressive.
A free kick awarded by the referee. This could be a chance.
Sadio Mane again. Elbow. Oh,
he
did some fancy shit and then he finished it off.
Insulted to the wounds. It's been a one-horse race out there today.
Mane doesn't get another goal, but Sadio Mane adds to his Premier League tally. And it's goal from open play. For a penalty. Alba makes it 5-0 and Southampton are convincingly defeated. Love to see that. Love to see my rivals dropping points. Spurs didn't, which is annoying, but Man United did.
Manchester United 2, Swansea City 2.
Also, is it wrong that I'm really happy that you know you got really bad injuries in your Europa League?
Tottenham Hotspur 4, Stoke City 0.
Oh, I mean, I'm how I you. So what I can't tell you how much I enjoy rubbing it in the faces of my Man United friends.
Tottenham Hotspur with 19 points. In fourth,
the friends I have who support them.
In fifth,
that said the Europa League would be easy. They'd win it no problems. Oh. Here's a big fucking problem. And you haven't fucking won it yet.
Rising up the table are Leicester.
Now they might not win it. One of the big reasons everyone was saying, oh, they'll win it no problem is because of Ibrahimovic. Now his career might be over. You know, which isn't, you know, I don't want anyone's career to end, but on one hand, it's like, yeah, but who cares? He's a Man United player. I mean, if he wasn't playing for Manchester United, I'd feel bad for him. But since he played for Manchester United, it's like, I have to feel bad for him. I have to say, ha ha, sucks to be you. Ha ha, you fucking big-nosed Swedish cunt. Fuck Ibrahimovic. I hope his career is fucking over. He shouldn't have come to the doom cloud that is Manchester United. And yes, I realized he's if Mourinho who can get United playing the way he wants to, they may very easily win some the next season. Hell, they could still win the Europa League without Rich. I mean,
this is today's Tottenham Hotspur team.
They've already shown that they are very capable of winning a game without him. I mean, just look at the Chelsea game.
Man of the match in his last game. And today, it's just the one striker in the
side. Sturridge! It's going to be a big miss.
Eriksen.
I mean, we'll have to see if Rashford is capable of taking United to glory. They may have to call on Wayne Rooney. I know that probably sickens Mourinho to the core. I don't think he likes Rooney. I don't know why, I just get that vibe anytime I see the United play. Hey, whenever I have to be forced to watch them. Because, you know, sometimes they're playing games
that
affect Liverpool, so I'm like, oh, for God's sake, I have to watch United. Damn it! I would much rather be doing anything else, like jumping off a skyscraper. Yeah, I would rather jump to my death than watch my AI, but fortunately I have to do sometimes.
So we've got
thankfully he not all the time. In only a few matches out of it.
And here's the header. Oh, well saved.
Sky Sports don't help. They always put the fuckers on the fucking TV.
Shots on here. Great save by a diving goalkeeper. Liverpool's corner. Fabulous clearance.
Oh crap. Whoo! That could have been bad. That could have been very bad. I thought for a second Jansen was going to get away from me there, but luckily, dude has no pace. If that were like a really fast striker, I might be fine. I like Spurs, they put out their full team. They're going for it.
Defended to it first.
They aren't playing it. They are like, no, we're not going to arrest our best players. We're going to risk them. If they get fucking injured or fuck up our Premier League season, who gives a shit? Oh, you can't be serious. How did you not score that?
That
Pereira. It's the post. It rolls across. It rolls on the line over to the side and doesn't go in. I was going to say rolls across the line, but that would make it sound like it rolled. It did go, which it didn't. It rolled on the line, is the best way to say it.
And headed towards where a teammate can gather the ball. Liverpool will get the throw.
Oh, fuck.
Well, they're in a good position
here. Sturridge. Into Moya, why? Why did you freaking... What was that? I don't know whether to be fucking frustrated or laugh. That was pathetic. I guess I'm fucking frustrated. What was that, Moya? For fuck's sake. It was probably the best opportunity we've had this whole game.
Into the attacking third. Good challenge here. Well, they passed their way up into a good position, and he could get away here.
Sturridge.
He's in the clear.
The shot. Ojo.
The defenders managed to get away there.
Yes. Van Bergen.
And the cross is in.
The deflection takes it safely in fact.
Good forward play from them.
Emery Moore.
Put them in front.
Go on, Emery. Yes. No. Ah. Fuck. shouldn't have hit that first time. It was instinct. I just hit circle. Come on, Daniel. If you want that new contract, you have to earn it.
Well, there's going to be 3 minutes added on.
I'll let your ass go on a free. Don't think I won't. Yes. Oh, fuck off, Pentongan. I know in my excitement, I butchered his name. Fuck it. I don't care.
Really good contest this.
Emery Moore. Straight from the kickoff. Go on.
But still a second half to go.
Yeah, here it is. Hit them the new one. Yes, in! That's more like it. That's much better, Emery. That is much better.
Shows if you do the difficult thing in the right areas and it comes off, this is what happens. You get a great goal.
Sometimes second you see goal in the competition.
And then it comes to nothing, but this fella made sure.
I don't know if he's. If you've ever noticed that, I don't know if that's a glitch in the game. I noticed whenever, if you were ever kicking off in the second half against the computer, try running at the goal direct from kickoff.
It's good work with the
because it's like the computer has to like boot up for the second half because it's like half asleep from half time. I said half a lot there. Yeah, you just saw how easy it was to rip them to shreds.
Oh, great work by the keeper.
Compared to the first half, the players looked like they were asleep. Now, maybe it's just a coincidence. Maybe the players are just
well to stop that tired.
But this, it happens a lot. Anytime I'm kicking off in the second half, like, I need a goal, I will use that to my advantage. Oh, even if you don't need a goal, just get it to really pile on the advantage you have.
Check on the corner count.
Even if it's completely redundant, like, if you're 5-0 up, adding on more misery to your opposition.
Possibility for Liverpool.
Right. You have no ties to that team.
Just a little nudge.
If you say, this team doesn't deserve a complete trashing. Yes, they do. Yes, they do. Every team deserves a complete trashing. If you can.
Yeah, it's got a good
dish out. It's complete trashing. You need to give one out. Not only will it help goal difference and stuff like that, it'll help morale. Your player's morale will go fucking way up, and their player morale will go down. And that'll affect them in their next game. You never know. That might lead to them fading away in the title race if they're title team. Like, this could be a good opportunity to really screw over Tottenham. If I can beat them, by a convincing score line, which doesn't look like it's going to happen, looks like it's going to be just 1-0 well, at this point, but if I were to beat them by a convincing score line, that might affect them in the next Premier League match, and they might drop points.
Sturridge! Great stop.
Of course, if there were a league game, they'd be dropping points anyway because
they're playing Chelsea in the next match.
And, I would be too even.
Hugo Lloris with a save.
You understand what I'm saying?
I hope. Can be very demanding.
If I'm not making any sense, I apologize.
I'm not sure we're going to see it, and I don't think the players believe either, Martin.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here. Not a great cross at all in the circumstances.
Hey, what are you doing? Oh, Trippier! Oh, he should equalise there. He denied by the post.
What does this mean, Alan, for their next
surge?
Yeah, Spurs.
Costa Perenna.
West Bromwich Albion. Well, here's a chance. Well, that's a great interception.
Yeah, that's exactly why her contract is whittling down, Sturridge. He was looking for the ball. Oh, did he make a run? Did he make a run to warrant me passing the ball to him? I knew. Oh, he stood there like you were, like, waiting for... Oh, okay, pass the ball. Dude, you're behind me. I'm in a better scoring position than you. No, pass me the ball. That makes no fucking sense.
A chance to attack.
Plus there's Spurs players all around you.
Wonderful chance.
Yes! A second goal right at the depth. Ah.
Liverpool have got the goal. We'll talk about luck. The keeper makes a good save.
I don't know what the fuck caused the Pereira. I kind of like it. He kind of like... I don't know if I accidentally did a fake shot. I don't even know how to do them. But, you know, it kind of looked like he went to take a shot, but then it's like, nah, I'm not going to take the shot at all.
And that's the final whistle from the referee.
Well, it was all crazy. 2-0 win. I'm through. Spurs are out. Good job. Made no fucking sense whatsoever, but hey, whatever. But hey.
English League Cup. Blackpool.
Crazy bullshit.
Bradford City.
Crazy bullshit.
Charlton Athletic 1, Bournemouth 1.
I'll take it.
Stoke City 2.
Next game is going to be huge. Chelsea.
Hotspur 0.
He's second in November? Yeah, November. Fucking hell, we're in May. We're November 9th. Of 2019 already. Fucking hell, the time flies quick. Ah, I thought this keeper would be good. I might as well offer this guy a contract to be a future first team player, why not? No reason to leave him just sitting there alone. Oh, don't worry, Coutinho. I would never pick Costa Pereira over you. Ooh. I don't know if this guy is the future of this club like he would think, like me to think he is. He did go up. That's good to see, Nicholas. Keep doing that. Everyone around him is 27 or 28. And Sula's just sitting there like, wow, I'm the youngest guy here. In the defense, yes. The youngest player in the whole team is Renato. In the first 11, I should say. Good mix of youth and experience. Think I'd want to replace those old players. Nah, no reason to. Right now. Is that the... Aw, man. That's the... Oh no, that is the fifth game. Okay. So in the next episode, I should hopefully beat Chelsea, who will be losing their first game of the season. Spurs will probably go up in second, because why the hell wouldn't they? Do not show this to a Newcastle fan now. I mean, the league table is crazy, man. Man City 6th, Arsenal in 8th, and while Bournemouth and Sunderland are in 4th and 5th, Manchester United, 15th. They have 9 points! I mean, this it's great, but they have nine. How do Man United have 9 points? Means with the team they have, they should be right up there, or in the top four, or if not directly below me. Like seriously, they have all the players, and no, that's not what I wanted to do. Search players. Seriously. You're telling me they have the team I'm going to show you, and they're not even challenging me? Chelsea and Spurs are challenging me, and Man United aren't. I mean, I'm happy to see them struggling, but for fuck's sake, they shouldn't be. I mean, Griezmann, Kane, Lacazette. 91, 90, 88. They have three of the best strikers in the world. Hold. And they're not anywhere near me. I have no idea who the fuck this guy is. Kane is meh, and Wilson is meh. Midfield. I suppose they have Barkley, who's 87. Oh, I didn't expect him to be that high. Maybe that's why they spent so much fucking money on him. They have Kovacic, who's a lot lower than I expected him to be. Mkhitaryan's still here. Pogba's fucking 94 rated. How is he higher rated than fucking all my players? What the fuck have United done? They've done nothing, and he's growing like a fucking weed. Rooney is whittling away to nothing. Ashley Young is still here. Why? Chanelogu, wow, they have Chanelogu. You fucking cunts. You have one of the best midfielders. He is super underrated. I don't care what the fuck what kind of bullshit it surrounded him in real life. He's still one of the good young players. There's the fact that they have him and they're not using him to his full potential is a fucking crime. If I had a place for him, he would be in my team. They still have Alberto Moreno, for what reason, I don't know. Ibai, who hasn't grown as much as I expected him to. Luke Shaw is somehow still here. He probably won't be a Man United player in the next game, because Mourinho fucking hates him as well. Chris Smalling, he's only going to play one. He's another player you'd expect to grow a good bit. I mean, their goalkeeper choices are meh. I mean, they do have Ryan here. But, eh. I suppose some of their team is meh. I mean, no, maybe they could go. Like, if I were to make a suggestion about a goalkeeper, you know? That's the thing, they sold De Gea, and they haven't replaced him. They're like, they fucking brought in Adrian. Randolph has replaced Adrian in the West Ham team. Wait, why am I missing the game? I'm continuing on directly after this video. I'm recording another video. I don't know what I'm doing. Oh yeah, that's right, I'm ending the video over here. Thanks for watching, hope you enjoy, smash the like button if you did, subscribe if you're new, and until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.